Good afternoon, everyone. This is Kevin Gianni from the Renegade Health Show here at Hodo Soy for one more episode. This is where the rubber hits the road here. We're actually going to see how tofu is produced. I've never seen this before, and I'm thrilled to be able to show it to you because I was curious, and I hope that you enjoy what we go through now. So check it out.
Essentially, tofu making has sort of two critical steps.
Okay.
One is you have to make the soy milk.
Yep.
So this unit right here is our soy milk machine. And what it essentially does is it grinds up the beans,
yep.
It cooks it, and it separates the bean pulp from the milk.
Okay.
Okay? So when we come over here, I'll show you how that works.
Okay. Come on. Here are the beans here.
So we start with organic non-GMO soybeans here. These are really nice, rich, high-protein soybeans that we source from the Midwest.
Can you tell the difference, or?
You can't.
Yeah.
You have to look at documentation. We know it's ready when it's evenly colored.
Yeah.
You know, and we soak these overnight, just
okay.
Like you would any beans.
Okay.
Once this is soaked, we grind it. And so, be careful here. This is our grinder. It grinds up the beans into a slurry, you know, a mush.
And there's no additional water in there?
There is some additional
okay.
water, because otherwise it's really hard to grind.
Okay.
We use a traditional grinder.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And then that slurry essentially gets pumped up to this cooking tank. And this is where sort of like quality is separated. Okay.
Okay.
We make a soy milk that's almost twice as thick as what you would in the industry.
Okay.
It's kind of like skim milk versus Strauss milk.
Okay.
That's how I like it.
Okay.
You can do a lot of things with Strauss thick milk, you know, but you can't do it if it's like highly skim with skim milk.
Okay.
So we liken our soy milk to a thick, rich, you know, cream and milk. It's important because that translates to a richer tasting, better tasting tofu in the end.
Okay.
So it's basically twice as expensive
right.
for us to produce this than the highly commoditized one.
It's amazing, right?
Yeah.
And then how hot does it get in here? How hot?
We cook that up to 100 degrees Fahrenheit.
Okay.
You know, I'm sorry, Celsius.
Celsius. Like, wait a minute.
So, now 200 plus degrees. Under pressure. So now, once that's cooked, we can go over here and you can see this is the okara, the bean pulp that I was telling you earlier about. Essentially, this goes to hog farmers.
Okay.
You know, it's
that
basically.
It smells really strong.
Yeah, it smells really rich. It's actually edible.
Okay.
You know, it's like it's like grits.
Like grits?
Yeah.
Okay.
It's high fiber.
Yeah.
High protein. So very valuable.
Okay.
And we produce a lot of it. So we sell it to a hog farm. The beans will get separated. I mean, the milk will get separated. And it's going to come out into this holding tank.
Okay.
So now the milk is out. It gets pumped again to the coagulation unit where tofu is.
Oh, okay.
So you see the pipe that goes all the way across.
Wow.
And then what do you do with this?
That is also the final okara.
Oh, okay.
Know? This is truly like baby food.
Okay.
We also give that to the farm.
Okay.
We also use some of it to make some of our sauces.
Okay.
So, what you're looking at here is the coagulation unit. Everything we make here follows the artisanal traditional process.
Okay.
We just have these machines to help mechanize, to make the process a little bit more precise.
Yeah.
But the process is exactly the same whether you do it by hand or machine.
Okay.
Essentially, the soy milk is mixed with a coagulant called calcium sulfate.
Yeah.
And then it forms a curd. So you can see it happening right here. So in about 30 seconds, you know, this will move one spot. The soy milk will basically drop into the bowl. The coagulant will drop in there as well.
Okay.
And there it is.
all it does is that's all it needs to do to mix it.
That's what it does.
Yeah.
And then what you have is a curd like this.
No. How long does it take to curd?
About 30 seconds.
Oh, really? That quickly?
Oh, wow.
And so this curd now has a lot of water. This is the equivalent of silken toast.
Okay.
And you're going to see right over here, the blade's going to come down, it's going to break up that curd.
Okay.
That process releases the water.
Okay.
The protein of the soy milk and the coagulant bind together, but it's not a very strong bind. So what you have is it's a loose bind, so water starts releasing very quickly.
Okay.
And you see it on the other one, on the other side. So here you can see the curd is now broken and it comes into these trays. And this is very much like cheese making. You know, you have a curd and you separate the curd from the whey. And that's what these guys are doing. The cheesecloth allows you to press the whey away. It's like folding a present. You can see the tofu coming out. And we cut them into shape.
Okay.
So these are already finished pressed tofu, firm tofu.
And then package them just like that. And this is
we
for you.
Package them, and then we also cool them down.
Oh, okay.
So basically, firm tofu. Firm tofu is fresh. We basically want to package them as soon as possible,
right.
Cool them down, and get them ready to ship out.
Right. And then these would be shipped to wholesale.
Exactly.
Yeah.
We introduced yuba here. We're the only company that makes yuba, fresh yuba. It forms a sheet like this.
Well, explain what it is.
So yuba is essentially the cream of soy milk. Now, if you drink Strauss milk, the cream rises to the top. That's essentially what this is. It's protein and fat that if you keep it warm, it will rise to the top. And each sheet takes about 3 minutes to get a sheet like that.
Let's say 3 minutes. Okay.
Yeah. And it's highly prized because you can do a lot with it.
Yeah.
Have you had any of our yuba products?
I have, yeah.
So it's basically the sashimi of tofu. People just love eating this.
Well, I think the coolest thing is you can make it into noodles.
Yes. You shred that and that becomes a noodle.
Yeah.
And you can toss it in a pesto sauce. You can stir fry it. It always stays al dente because there's really no starch in it.
Yeah.
Just protein.
Yeah.
So, people really love our yuba.
And then when you cook it, if you cook it, you don't even need to cook it. I mean,
you don't. You can eat it fresh as is.
Yeah.
Or you can stir fry it. You can throw it into soup. It always stays maintained this really delicious texture and flavor.
Right.
Very versatile.
Essentially, your favorite dish.
So here, this is.
You haven't had it?
Spicy yuba strip. No, I've not had this before.
He's gonna be a convert after this, right?
Try this out here.
You
better be. See if
can't
I can
blame
him.
Him.
Do the chopsticks, though.
Can't blame him. Billy?
Go ahead.
That's so good.
I will. Don't mind if I do.
The texture of that yuba is just amazing.
There's nothing like it.
It's like a really nice, firm noodle. Yeah.
All protein.
And the sauce is amazing. Good stuff.
Your question of the day is this. Have you ever seen tofu produced? Did you know that it was produced this way? Yes or no? Go ahead and post that down below. Kevin Gianni from the Renegade Health Show. Together we can change the health of the world one show at a time.